Hi, I'm Cheryl Hunter. This video is about how to deal with naysayers, dream crushers, and people who would otherwise try to discourage you from what's in your own heart. I got an email from Linda who asked, "What shall I do? I'm about to start my own bakery, which is something I've longed to do forever, but the people closest to me are trying to talk me out of it. How could people do that?" Well, Linda, let me provide something. If you look at them as just naysayers, as just people who are trying to discourage you from your dream, it may not provide the most power for you, particularly in having a good relationship with them. So I want to provide a different perspective. I've got a client named Casey who's committed to being a wife and mother. She and her fiance Nick have been together for a year and a half. He's already proposed. And he said that he doesn't want to set the date for the marriage yet until he's clear that he can provide for Casey and their family. Now, he's got a great job, he works in financial services, and everything seemed to be on track until last week. Casey's fiance Nick came home and said that he has decided he wants to scrap what he's doing and become an actor. Casey was like, "No!" Now, why? Because she sees her dream going out the window with his being fulfilled. So people might be naysayers because they've got their wagon hitched to yours in some way, but they also might be naysayers. Take the perspective that it's said that something like 80% of businesses fail in the first 3 years. Now, maybe the people closest to you are truly concerned about you and they want to protect you. But ultimately, what's most important is, are you going to look at and listen to what the naysayers are putting in your face as something to stop you, or are you going to look at it as something to fortify you? Here's a great example. When I left high school, my sister and I decided that we wanted to move to England. We're from a tiny town up in the mountains, and it was seemingly impossible. We were one day before we were moving to England, we were at the mall in the town nearby, and a woman, Mary, who used to work in our lunchroom in the cafeteria, came up to us and said, "Well, what are you girls doing this summer? And what are you up to with your lives?" And we said, "Well, we're moving to England." And she laughed hysterically and goes, "Bet you don't." Now, at the time, my sister and I were like, "Oh, how could someone say that?" Now, who knows? She went off down the mall waving and laughing and screaming, "Bet you don't, bet you don't." And my sister and I used that phrase to egg each other on when one of us thought of quitting or giving up. We'd go, "Oh, bet you don't. Well, I bet you don't. Well, I bet you don't." And it became the thing that fortified us. Who knows why people say what they do? Who knows why naysayers are naysayers? It's not going to provide any value to try to go down that road and figure out why they do what they do. What's more important is, how are you going to use that? Are you going to use it to fortify you or take you out of the game? I would love to hear from you. Where have you been allowing naysayers to take you out of the game? Where are you now going to be fortified by it? What you have to say makes a difference, and I would love to hear your thoughts. If you like this video, share it with a friend. Subscribe to my channel. For more premium content, head over to CherylHunter.com. If you've got ideas for videos, pop me an email on the website and just let me know. In the meantime, have your life make a difference.